For Africa, what should we be seeing in terms of capacity building moving forward? I will start by just emphasizing that we need capacity building support for all countries at different levels. And we're talking at individual, institutional, and also systemic capacity that need to be enhanced. And in particular, there are some specific groups that need to be targeted. I will name just a few of these groups in terms of what we need to be lobbying for. In terms of scientists, I think we've heard different speakers talking about the importance of science in terms of our role as Africa in climate change moving forward. But some of the recommendations I would like to make here is that we need to lobby for funding. Funding for climate science should actually specifically target scientists in terms of making sure that they continue to produce the data that we need to inform us about what's going on and therefore make decisions on those bases, but also to increase the knowledge and skills around climate-related sciences. These scientists also need to develop capacity to communicate scientific information in a way that makes it meaningful to those who are supposed to use this information. And that will include, indeed, policymakers. It will include the media, so that the stories that they produce to inform the public are very well informed by the information that comes from science, but in a way that they will not distort the information. I will also look at policymakers. Policymakers need capacity building to make appropriate use of facts on climate change, that on facts that are made available to them, and also to be able to develop climate resilience policies. Unless they can make use of that information, we'll continue to have scientists doing what they are doing and doing it very well, but seeing that information falling right into the cracks because the policymakers are not able to use it to develop policies that are relevant for us to change. I would also like to see capacity building enabling Africa's access to affordable modern technologies so that we are able to advance our green economy. As Africa, we are dependent on certain commodities for our economy. I'll make an example of South Africa being dependent on coal for production of energy. Now, for a long time, we're not going to have any alternative means of producing energy, as much as everybody knows that coal is dirty. But what can help us shift from our current position is if one can then get technologies that will assist us to use the commodities we have, but in a green, using a green technology that will cause less pollution to the environment. We also need to increase pollution to the environment. We also need to increase that will cause less pollution to the environment. Pollution to the need to increase that will cause less pollution. We also need environment. Pollution to the need to increase that will cause less pollution. We also need environment. To them. So we need to enhance this capability. But most of all, coming from an S&T sector, I would like to emphasize the urgency of technology transfer to enable Africa to transit to low carbon development technology. And this transfer of technology, I think, should be accompanied by technology assessments. I would like to emphasize the it should be accompanied by and this transfer of technology I think I would like to emphasize the it